Pyrazines are a family of compounds that we in wine experience usually as sort of vegetal-like flavors, oftentimes described as bell pepper, green bean, jalapeno, chili kind of like characteristics. And pyrazines are sensitive to ultraviolet light. Chemists call it photodegradation. And what that means is the exposure of the fruit to ultraviolet light. So let's just say if the fruit doesn't have a lot of shading from the leaves around it, there's more light penetration from the sun that can actually hit the fruit. The light, the ultraviolet light itself, actually changes the flavor compounds inside the grapes. In a cool area like the Willamette Valley, with our northern latitude, also the fact that the hottest part of the day is usually around 5 p.m. in the summer, the sun is at a 45 degree angle, we are seeing a tremendous amount of ultraviolet light that gets exposed to the fruit, or vice versa. In a region like California, and also in Washington State, for example, we don't really have that opportunity because the sun is actually too strong, the heat that's there is too intense, and the fruit will actually burn. And so because of that, we oftentimes see examples at much, much higher alcohol contents from both of those regions that still retain a significant amount of pyrazine compounds because they're unable to get the ultraviolet light that we have at the temperatures that are low enough to be able to keep the fruit safe and to be able to have this process of photodegradation of the pyrazines. So when people taste the Cabernet Franc that we produce, they can't wrap their brain around it. And I don't mean a consumer or, I mean, the highest levels of professionals that we can think of in our industry that have tasted and experienced our wines can't wrap their brain around it. It just doesn't seem to make sense. And there's really just this very, very simple principle of chemistry and understanding how that functions. And it's a happy accident because the way that we farm in the Willamette Valley, we have a lot of pressure from humidity in the spring where we can tend to have significant powdery mildew threats. Later on, towards the end of the season, in mid to late September, we start to have off and on periods of rain, which then can bring botrytis and other damage. And so we culturally actually expose the fruit significantly in order to be able to make sure that we have a lot of wind and light and everything to be able to try to mitigate those disease pressures. And as a result, we've accidentally discovered this very simple principle, which is well understood, and it has expressed itself through our Cabernet Franc in a really extraordinary way.
And that's one of the beauties of Cabernet Franc in the Willamette Valley, is that it can actually hang through those autumn rain events much more effectively than a thinner skinned variety like Pinot Noir can. So Cabernet Franc gives us the ability to expand our harvest and our cellar work for an extra 6 to 8 weeks because of its thicker skins, looser cluster morphology, and its ability to really hang through the elements that make the Willamette Valley, you know, a cool maritime temperate region.